reset on like 10 day ones before like a run. Like, it's not actually like a bad sign. That's just part of the speedrun. I'm not at all shook. It's just annoying. If you're getting shook by failing day one like 7 times, I'm like sorry, but it's like, you know, don't. Just don't get shook. Just don't do it. Can't get shook from the small stuff, otherwise the big stuff will shake you worse. Especially because all of these day ones have been screwed up because I've been sort of bad. Good. Good. Ish. I'll take it compared to all the others. Well, it's like Kaizen, who, you know, resets on like 30... He resets 30 times between day 1 and day 3 in an all-treasure speedrun. And I'm like, okay, Kaizen, you are crazy. It is crazy to not be okay with a 123 day one on a 4-hour speedrun. But whatever. Oh no. Whatever, I dealt with that quickly enough. Not Kaizen though, Kaizen hates that shit. Score attempt runners are actually more reasonable than doing resetting day one on all treasures. The score attempts, it's very short, but it has to be perfect, right? It's like Blue Onion. I sort of think score attempts are more like Blue Onion than anything else, right? Because it's just like, oh, it's only like... I mean, it's only like 4 minutes of Pikmin play. But if you fuck up even a little bit, then it's like, destroy. It's the Japanese mindset of... Robot. Honestly, my new goal, if we're gonna be honest, is 142.33. Because I now want to be better than Kaizen's time scale. If I can be better than Kaizen's time scaled, that'd be dope. I feel like that would be, that'd be a big up if I could do that. Including COS4. COS4 is part of the math for Pokos, right? The easier way to do it Because Lugia, you also have to factor in the fact that they always skip GK2 and Whitefire Garden 4. So 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 what happens is, Louie, is they actually lose like 330, but then they save 130. Or not skipping, or not that. It's probably just like 3 and 2, right? Where they just you think they lose more, but then you remember that they skip some shit, and then it's like, oh well, then it's only 2 minutes. And thanks, Ipsati, for the good luck. I forgot if I said that already. I'm tired. But yeah, faster than Kaizen scaled is the goal. Kaizen himself said, I believe he said it was 2 minutes himself back when he was talkative for 5 seconds, like 5 months ago. In any case, yeah. So I don't want to. I don't really. 141 is maybe like a long time future goal, but I'd be happy with sub scaled Kaizen. Which is around 142.33-ish. I don't remember the exact time, something like that though. Mindset though, I think do you know why I hate that, Lugia? I hate it because it never works in reverse, right? In other speed games, in other ones, no one ever is like, oh man, that person's like actually his world record because he's on the US version, which is slower than all the Japanese runners running on the JP version, right? Like, no one ever says that because it's just like, that's not how speedrunning works. It's, if you don't want to get a better category, then I don't know. I think Kaizen is still a more skilled Pikmin runner overall than me, especially considering his All Treasures time. But it's like, I don't know. I just don't like generally that line of thinking. I don't think it's productive or helpful. I know they're better, but they're not faster than me. He's literally not faster than me in Payoff Debt. That's why I think it's like a stupid distinction. It's like, well yeah, Kaizen's better than me, and it's like, well I don't really care. I'm faster than him in Payoff Debt. That's sort of what I care about more. It'd be great if I could be better than Kaizen's time scaled, but it's not. I can't make, and this for the sake of competition, it'd be great if Kaizen and IID actually got US version and then just told us all what was up, right? But it's like, I can't make them do that. Yeah, but that's a stupid distinction, right? It's like, well, then if he doesn't get, it doesn't matter, right? Like, oh man, I'm sorry that the Japanese are too lazy to get the US version. If Kaizen's too lazy to figure out how to do what pretty much every other runner on the face of the planet has been doing since speedrunning existed, then he doesn't deserve a world record. I'm sorry, that's my hot take. You can't just be like, oh, well, someone actually has world record because he runs on a different version with, I don't know. I think that's a dumb way of thinking about it. It's just like, oh, well, he theoretically would be have world record if he did. It's like, well, yes, well, Ghostly would have my world record if, you know, if he didn't play like a fucking dumbass on all the above ground shit. Don't quote me on that, but he does. And he's only 14 seconds behind me, right? He loses way more than 14 seconds on not actually being smart on above ground at all, right? So it's like, you know, people live and die by the decisions they make. Kaizen has decided not to think about getting US version, so he's going to be slower than me and half dead. That's how that works. That is the decision-making process that Kaizen has decided, right? Well, yes. But I guess that's not really the point, right? Speedrunning doesn't work by who's theoretically better than who. It's who has the fastest time. That's why I think it's a counterproductive way of thinking about speedrunning. Ghostly is better than me, right? It's just that Ghostly's stubborn, and because he's stubborn, he's slower than me. Right? I don't think I'm better than Ghostly, if we're actually going to be honest. If we're being super rigorous, I am not better than Ghostly. But I'm faster than Ghostly because Ghostly is stubborn. And that's how the game, because that's how speedrunning works. No, I don't actually think I'm a better runner than Ghostly. Time isn't equal to skill, but time matters. Skill doesn't matter. That's my point, dude. In speedrunning, skill doesn't matter. Time is literally what matters. That's my whole point. If we want to make a skill ranking leaderboard, that's cool, but that's not how speedrunning works. It's a time leaderboard. I have a faster time, therefore I'm first. That's how, I don't know. I think that's the only way I think about it, right? I mean, who are the actual top five in skill in RTA, right? It's IID, then Kaizen, and then Ghostly, probably, and then Urban, and then myself, right? So I'm probably fifth RTA. What do you mean it's not? I'm just saying, okay, like, I'm admitting to you that I'm fifth in skill, but who cares, right? Being fifth in skill doesn't mean I magically don't have world record anymore, right? I'm not delusional about my own skill. I'm actually very, very aware of how good I am. Well, yes, no. But, no, I mean, this is my point, right? I'm not saying I'm a god. I mean, I am one of the best, sure. And I've proven that, hopefully. But I don't think I'm better than Ghostly or Urban. But it's... Oh, okay. I don't know, dude, you're just saying it's not, and I don't know if that's just arguing against me or, like, any case. I don't know, that's why I do sort of get tired over, like, who's better than who. It's like, who cares? Put your money where your mouth is. Well, especially with the other US runners, it's like, yeah, Ghostly's better than me, but he should just learn how to play, he should just learn above ground. Put your money where your mouth is. You know, like, oh man. It's like, and for the JP runners, it's like, look, I know for a fact there's definitely, you know, God knows they're smart enough to understand homebrewing. Goodness knows there's probably a website in Japanese that talks about it. They just don't. It's just not, it's a mindset thing. Their mindset is holding them back from getting world record and payoff debt. And so, you know, I can't be their keeper, right? We are not beholden to the fact that they don't understand what the hell they're doing. They also put in way more time than we do. I don't know. I'm sort of okay with them being faster than me, because I'm sorry, if I'm going to be real, I have a job, right? I'm not saying they don't have a job, but have you seen Kaizen's AT counter? he has the run attempts counter, right? In the last week, it's gone up by like 350, right? He's done 350 attempts in the last week, right? I get a lot of those are day one resets, but still. Like, the Japanese just run way more than we do and run more rigorously than we do. Right? I know I'm definitely better than early blues than Kaizen. Kaizen soft locks way more than any of the rest of us. It's not even drama. It's just like, I don't know. I just get tired of the conversation. It's like, yes, the Japanese have like a way better speedrunning work ethic than we do. But at the same time, they're also stubborn. And I don't know. I'm just like, you know, you live by the sword and you die by the sword a little bit there, you know? But yes, if Kaizen and I were to go toe-to-toe, he would stomp me, because I'm like, yes. I don't want to be too mean, because I feel like it's not really my place to be. It's like, I don't know, like, I also go out on, like, Saturday nights, and it's like, sometimes I'm just like, yo, don't people, like, y'all have shit to do? Maybe the answer is no, man, I'm not gonna judge too hard. I mean, I still speedrun the game like everybody else, but it's just like, yo, like, I don't know. I could devote more time. It's not like I couldn't. I could drop out, I could get, like, a retail job, and then I could just, you know, not go out on Friday and Saturday nights and just play more Pikmin 2. I mean, I feel like I'm very, very, very good considering the time and effort I've put in, which is a lot, but also at the same time a measured amount over the last year and a half. Honestly, this run has been probably excluded from GDQ submission no matter what, because I've basically been talking about, like, just... By the Japanese, I mean the Japanese runners, but it's like, yeah, this probably would sound bad out of context. Whatever. RIP. I honestly need to, like, look at Kaizen's run again, though. I just feel like that there's this, like, I feel like that we don't actually learn. I feel like that we learn from each other really well, but we don't learn from the Japanese at all. We should just watch more of their runs, honestly. I haven't studied Kaizen's run in, like, 5 ever. Just like sub-levels, right? You can't study everything and compare times, because that doesn't... It's the Japanese version, right? Like, you can't do that, but you can still look at what he does. Like, again, Pikmin 2 isn't, like, magic, right? Like, there's no, like, you know, it's just, it's all just Pikmin management and, like, among other things, you know? Like, what they're doing isn't that, can't be that much crazier than what I'm doing. And also, I mean, let's not pretend like they're just magic, right? Like, Kaizen, to get the 144, Kaizen had to grind for, like, a long time. It's not like they magically just go and get 144s when they try. But yeah, I guess that's my 2 cents. mean, they're magic if we don't see it, but even so, right? Like, it takes them a while, right? I mean, how many AT runs? Again, that's my point, right? Like, between his PB, Kaizen has, I think, literally done 600 run attempts. Between his AT PB and now, right? So his next AT PB is probably gonna be like, I don't know. I'm losing all my time save here, by the way. This was bad. Really bad 4. Really bad 1, really bad 3, really bad 4. Yikes. I can't get time save if I have a really bad 1, a really bad 3, and a really bad 4. That's like all the sub levels, guys. Still do that, though. But it's just like, look, I'm at 112 now, right? It's like, what if I just... I mean, I would hope that I actually would, by the time I hit, like, 1700, right? 1800, like, 700 run attempts from now. If I really grinded it, I hope I would actually get a 142.30. Fast treasure. I don't know. I also don't really even feel that bad, because Kaizen was around before I was even here. So there's still a little bit of like, oh. I also want to run AT more, because I feel like it's cliche, but like, it helps you in payoff debt, and it also is just sort of like, I don't know, a much more extreme metric of skill, right? Like, yeah, I'm faster than Ghostly in payoff debt, but like, Ghostly's better than me, right? Like, look at his AT time, right? I'm like, oh god, I just got a 445, granted, like, fourth completed run or some shit, but like, oh god, 445, he's like, yeah, I'm down here being 40 minutes faster than you, and I'm like, whoops, yikes. So I'm just like, you know, I think that's like, actually sort of like, the true. I think if I'm faster in Ghostly in both main categories, then I'm probably better than him. I hate the moneymaker so much. I just abhor it. I don't know. The only reason, if we're gonna be honest, why I sort of abhor talking about skill level is that I feel like it contributes nothing. The only thing that it does in my mind is like disenfranchise people like myself. Whereas it's like, you know, like saying that Kaizen is better than me achieves nothing, mostly because A, I know Kaizen's better than me, but then it's like, well, if you're saying that, then what's the point? You know, then it's like, usually what the implication is, not that anyone here means this, but usually when people say things like that, the implication is like, Kaizen's better than you, therefore you don't deserve world record. And I think that's what's actually toxic. I know no one here says that, or even necessarily meant that, but like, I feel like that's like what's implied a lot of the time, you know? Where people are like, well, Kaizen's better than you. I'm like, well, yes. Doesn't mean he paid off debt in 142.58 though.
Oh.
I also feel like, frankly, it also opens up a whole other can of worms about theoretically skillful. Like, I actually think MoKG's MoKG basically has, like, only run a handful of times in 147s, right? But, like, he isn't faster than IID until he goes faster than IID, even though he's definitely, skill level-wise, much faster than 146, right? But it doesn't really matter if MoKG's skill level is 146, he has to, like, do it, you know what I mean? Again, I know no one here was saying I don't deserve the record, but I just feel like that's sometimes what's implied. That is also, both, the reverse is also true, right? Like, you're not automatically worse because you're slower. I mean, I don't know, I guess my point is, right, the reason why I've been saying is, you know, I acknowledge those that are better than me. Even people like Ghostly. But I also feel like it's hard, right? Like, how good is MoKG? Well, it's hard because he has a 147 that he hasn't submitted, and he's done, and he has like 15 attempts under his belt, right? So MoKG might be more skilled MoKG actually might be a better Pikmin 2 player than I am, right? But then that's why I think it always gets sort of tricky, right? It's like, well, you know, at the end of the day, you can talk a lot of game about people's theoretical skill level. But if you aren't eventually results oriented, you're just gonna go insane. Because everything just gets way too complicated otherwise. Not bad though, sort of a bad path, right? Because I gotta bring it all the way around. I also feel like, frankly, our community isn't so toxic, with the exception of maybe. Yeah, Kaizen, well, that's different, because he has the run, it just isn't... it's on a different version. Well, that's why I want a 4230, because then I'm actually, I'm quote-unquote... See, but then it's like, what's the... Well, right, well, that's why I want to be faster than that, right? So it's like, look, Kaizen, you actually have to run a better JP time if you want to say that you are, even in theory, faster than I am, right? Like, that's the goal. Even if I get, say I get a 140-150, say I keep me by a minute, right? And I get like a 140-159, I still think I'm better than Kaizen, right? This is why I think it's also sort of like stupid and hopeless, right? In sort of a nihilistic way, right? Like, even if I get a 141, I'm not better than Kaizen, right? I'm just not. There's not a time I could get where I would be better than Kaizen, in my mind. Because I don't have the AT time to make that true. I mean, maybe if I got, like a 141 mid, maybe it'd be close. I still think it'd be close. I don't know. I just feel like that skill level is so hard. It's such a complicated thing, actually. I think skill level is really complicated. But I think what you could say, though, the least you could say is if I get, like, a 4230, then if I get that, then suddenly, well, I am then faster than Kaizen's time, even scaled. But I don't even know what that means, right? Because again, being faster than anybody doesn't mean shit, even if it's a scaled being faster, right? And then you get into this sort of weird thing where it's like, well, how much faster than someone do you have to be in order to be definitively better, right? And the answer is there is no such thing, right? Because skill isn't related to time. There's correlation, but that's sort of it. And I hate it because then it starts getting, the one reason why I like speedrunning is the objectivity, right? Like, you know, we can talk shop about who's better in the English world, for example. But I have the faster time than Urban, and that's that, sorta. And I like it because of the objectivity of it, right? Like, I'm a man of science. I like just like, oh, I did it in this time. That's the story, right? That's it. when you start talking about skill level, you suddenly lose, like, that entire point that I like. That's why I don't really like it, because it takes away from what I find valuable from speedrunning in the first place, which is just the raw objectivity. I don't know. How much faster than Kaizen's scale do I have to be better than him? The answer is, go fuck yourself, because there's no time that exists. Four? Five? Six? Seven. Seven attempts. Gross. The seven screwed me up. If they all drown, that's just the dumbest reset. You're supposed to carry me, idiots! Whatever. I don't know, I mean... Again, Lugia, I'm not trying to call you out, alright? I'm just thinking that it's just sort of an interesting... Whatever, just eat him. I don't care. Enough out of you. Still only lost 4 seconds. It's annoying, but it's fine. That's the first time the Snagger has ever given me trouble. Annoying because I guess it generates purple leaves. I think that's the more annoying part about it, right? Like, it gives me crap about... I mean, who gives a shit about, like, 3 reds, right? And yeah, I mean, I didn't mean to call you out. I just think it's, like, and I just think it's annoying. I don't know. I'm not a fan of that line of thinking. That's all, I guess. I don't really have anything else to say. It's just not how I like to think about things, because I sort of said this before, but I think it takes away, like, from how I think speedrunning should work. And I'm down to talk about skill level occasionally, but I just feel like it's just sort of like a silly sort of thing that means very little. Okay, no water at least. That's cool. I can work with that. Good. No mums. This is a fine layout. Like this. Like this layout is for the most part not bad, because for the simple reason that. For the simple reason that there's just no bugs. And that makes such a huge difference. Yeah, purple leaves suck. Glad I'm not dealing with them. Oh, Alright. So you see, this is pretty good. I will actually say the thing that annoys me the most about the JP times is actually just how hard it is to compare, right? Like, it's like, well, okay, Kaizen has a 12-minute XEX, right? But they have a 12-minute XEX when they do XEX5. So that's actually, so that 12:45 is actually like a 10:45-ish, maybe? It's like, ugh, annoying. Comparisons are really difficult. Stop it. Alright, this is still fine. Usually I have a purple with me still in case it's near a snitch. Good. Always go to the marble, yo. Always swarm, everyone. Always do it. Never don't do it. Never don't swarm. Swarming is the future. It's mad fast. Brief reminder that if you aren't swarming, you're probably bad. Anyways, that's a daily cap reminder. Swarm, please. Please. Please do that. I'm still mad that I have purple leaves from the snacker. That's what we sacrifice for this new route. Alright, now 5 has to be not the worst. Please. Where did my cursor go? Where is my cursor? Ah, I was blind for a second. I couldn't see my cursor. Right now, where is the hole? I should probably figure that out first. Oh no, there it is. Alright, cool. Good layout. And the whistle's coming in too, so it's good. I didn't have to waste any time getting it back. It's gonna be right there. Sub 7 exit is really good. So that's nice. I suppose. He's scripted. Oh my god, fuck off. Outside of you. Great. Alright, cool. I'm losing time on this split, but it's fine. And that's why it's fine. And there's no hole. Great. No. No. Bad. Bad. You will fuck right off, sir. No! No, 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 no. No, no, no. No, no, no. That's like the worst nightmare, dude. Sucks. I'm pretty mad. Yo, that was dumb. I'm losing about 40 seconds, but I have both treasures, and now I have air brake, so I have way too much money, is the short answer. So I'm probably gonna skip everything, probably, right? I should probably just skip XCX1 almost no matter what. Unless I get, like, the god layout on XCX1. Even then, right, it might be worth to skip. Yo, my cursor's right under him! How did none of those purples latch on? I've been failing this fight recently. No! What?! Oh my god. Dude, rip this... Rip this... Oh, bad run. Really bad run. Four seconds lost. Yeah, dude. Seriously, Cap, not like this. That was so bad. That lost me. That lost PB. PB's now dead. It's unfortunate, but it's probably true. That 24 seconds was the difference between having a PB-worthy run and not a PB-worthy run. It sucks, but... going though, since I have so much money. Shoot, I'm gonna activate the 40% cutscene because I have so much money.
That's all.
so mad. I'm so mad about that snagger hole. I'm actually, like, unconsolably angry. Yep, I'm gonna break 4,000. How much nectar did I get? Not having all this nectar also is really bad, especially when I have all the purple leaves, so screw it. Seriously? Lost a little bit of time there. Where did the party go? RNG. Alright, cool. Let's just keep moving. Actually is hot garbage. I'm so mad about it. I am, however, rich beyond my wildest dreams, so we'll keep it running. Only because I am rich beyond my wildest dreams. No, like, I'm seriously, like, mad rich. It's sort of dumb. Hello, Calamar. I lost 24 seconds to Pileated Fight, because I need to figure out why I'm not one-cycling him anymore. I've stopped one-cycling him as much. Sarah and I helped figure out that strat. I'm sort of mad. Like that FFZ emote. People don't FFZ emote enough in my chat. Now this one will be fine. It really just depends on the next couple caves. Because I am super rich. I am actually rich beyond my wildest dreams. Alright. I'm only saving around 20 seconds, but that's fine. Ugh. Oh, where did the party go? know what that means? I'm exactly 300 Pokos ahead. It's because I got Air Brake. You know I had to do it to him. And I got both treasures on SH6. So, that's what happens when you get Air Brake and you get lucky. The problem is I lost 24 seconds to Pileated, so this could have been really good. And now it's just sort of good. But this could have been really good. If you know what I mean. Like, this could have been like the God Run. Yeah, that's pretty, yeah, it's pretty good. 300. Oh man, let's get some Craigasm for that exactly 25 Pikmin. Sorry, exactly 100 Pikmin. Only two leaves too, actually. That's pretty good considering I actually usually have a little bit more. Please don't wake up the Bulborb. Thank you. That was bad. Whoops, I threw too many. That's okay. Start putting my money where my mouth is. Let's skip some stuff. Great! No! No, no, no! Down! Put me down. EKRNG! It's a sign. It's a sign, ladies and gentlemen. It's a sign. It's a sign from the gods. EKRNG told me that I was to skip this. Party go. God damn it. Aim. I'm gonna pluck all you guys, don't worry. I'm not gonna leave my Pikmin to die. Oh, Calamar, I'm gonna remember that one, dude. You're too good. No, this is really good. This is what we in the business call good gameplay, I suppose. Or nearing it. A bummer about the bomb placements that slowed everything down, but aside from that, you know, can't complain. I can skip something on 3 as well, and then I can skip Manet Legs. So hopefully very short. Come on. on. These cycles are really bad. Where did the party go? Yeah, dude, I can skip everything. Skipping tape is bad. Tape is usually really close. I'm gonna skip Man at Legs, and then I'm going to skip, hopefully, Joy Receptacle, White Goodness. Or I can skip another 100 Poco, and either in Frontier Cavern 3 or Frontier Cavern 4. And get Love Nugget if I need to. So I can skip a lot. I think just saying skip things that might be good is silly. I have a plan. As it stands now, I can skip two more 100 treasures and get Love Nugget. Wait, no, I'm 300 ahead. I can just skip two 100 treasures. I can skip two 100 treasures and a small and get Love Nugget. Yeah, screw that. I'm fine. I'm doing nothing. Yeah, dude, AB is the future, because in the moment that you get a good snagger hole, you're like, wait, what the hell? No. Good. Get on my way, Olimar. Because FC3 and FC4 might be worse. There isn't actually a tricky question to that, right? It's just like. Oh. All right, sub 540, 5 exit. Not bad. God damn it. Alright, this was really bad. Oh god, this is really bad. See, one mistake in 6 is actually the run. If I had killed the poison geyser, that would have been the fastest in and out of all time. But I lost a minute here. Basically just being stupid. That's back here. It's not. No, I'm sorry. Do not compare what I did to what you did. Do not do that. This is still fine. It's just bad. I'm losing about a minute here on this cave. That's the problem with air break, right? Is that you can skip one and a man at legs, but if you fuck up a cave, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how badly. Good. Alright, double ring. I'm screwed. Geyser's really close. I can get away with only being plus a minute, but that's still too bad. You're supposed to be at this stage. You're supposed to be. I'm supposed to have a 9 minute if I get both. But I can still skip 100 Pokos, so I can still have a fast Frontier Cavern. Alright, close. Airbreak is the future. It's just I misplay on 6 cost me the run, and also the misplay on the Snaggered Hole, right? So like, those combined come to about a minute, right? Which is the difference between being fast and slow. Being plus 11 here is way better than being whatever the. Okay, what? Did not read my down input. Yeah, this is still too slow. Too fast. Cavern, behave, please. Please behave. Please clap. Seriously? Kill it! Want to double check something? Yep. I was pretty mad that they did not kill that Bulbord immediately. That was really, really slow. Bomb? Is there a bomb drop? I gotta check that bomb drop though. That bomb drop might slow me down. Now we're good. And we're getting a Bulbord and a dwarf out of it, so that's good. Alright, this is fine. Keep in mind, I can still skip 100 Pokos somewhere. If all of these are really good layouts, then I'm going to skip BLL. I'm assuming not one of them is going to be really bad, though, because that's usually how these things work. Exit here anyway, so it made sense to call the whites off the treasure because I knew I had to walk back. That's called a little bit of self-awareness. And you have to have a little bit of self-awareness if you want a PB on a 142. A little bit of self-awareness is required. In any case, this is fine. Oh, where did the party go? Where's the big boy? Okay, cool. Well, I found this one, so I'll just go here for a sec. Alright, cool. Oh, good! Big boy! Could it be? Oh god! Yes! 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 This is a good run. Boltman can only eat those three treasures, those three ones back there. I'll get you started on that and then I'll go kill the Boltman. Or I won't need to. Cool. Get fucked! RNG is good, everyone. I will have to kill this guy though. Come on. Dude, seriously, how, what? Are you stuck? No, you're not stuck, you're not stuck, you're not stuck. I was like, what? What? Game. I could just skip FC5 and just have like, V run. Eh. All right, give me a sec, game. Stop. Oh, it's back here. Five of six ain't bad. Time save is less BLL. That's what I thought, honestly. Thank you for reminding me. I was certain that it was not faster. Nope, no treasure that way. Good, that means we're in the same area. Also, those swooping snitch at the start is pretty fucking dance game. Where's the star? Oh wait, there's a star. Get fucked, idiot. Do I really care about... Oh man, where's the hole? It's over there, yeah. Cool. Alright. This is fine. Alright. Yeah, this is good. There are a couple of whites, and probably there are a couple of whites that are going to die to being planted, but I knew that in advance, and I'm gonna let it happen, because it can't be more than three. Alright. Five. Really bad five. I gotta kill, I can't just have you be this way. Dude, yes, please fucking kill all of them. Oh, the glove is over there, okay. Cutscene, please. Alright, cool. This is okay. Should've left the captain by the exit on FC3, but we take these. FC5 was a bit bad, had to kill three of them. But, can't complain, this is fine. Oh, where did the party go? Oh, cool. I'm ahead. There's no reason for me not to take that. Alright, cool. Yeah, so sub 830 Frontier Cavern exit is pretty good. Alright, cool. Let's just go this way. Bad. Okay, I'm starting to think I maybe should not take this way. Oh, actually, no, wait. Yeah, okay. I read it. Dude, seriously, can you not kill wolf orbs? What the hell is wrong? Yeah, I had to big brain a little bit. Does it? This is good. Yeah. So you're wondering how a 10-minute FC happens, Lugia. It happens around. This is sort of how it works. This is a gold split. Pretty clearly why. One of the best I've ever done. All right, cool. Oh, where did the party go? Okay, cool. And it's right there. I definitely can put 5 purples on it and some, Okay. Cool! Let's do this. So if I'm right, my end total should be around, I would say 50 if I'm fasting meal out, but yes. I can also gold this split, because surprise, this was, again, this gold is from the first time I ever did it, so lots to improve on there. Let's see how many reds I have. I should have a lot. Yeah. And I have a lot of blues. There's 26, so I only need to wait until I have less than 6. Now I have to pray that this behaves, so that it not bring purples. I think it will, though. Good. Come on, just get 5 on there. Thank you. My numbers are pretty good. I forgot to see how many purples I had. Yeah, courage reactor. Yep. Dude, imagine how good this would be if I had not choked XCX. SCX. Good. Wait, did I skip too much? Wait, I should have 100 to skip, but I don't. Unless I'm on drugs. No, I do. Okay, no, I do. I do. Yes. I have like a small to skip. Sorry, I forgot. My head was doing bad math. It's fine. Yeah, I'm good. It's all good. We're good. Alright, cool. 4 minutes is sort of like the standard there. I can't really get... trying to figure out how to get much faster than 4 minutes, and it's sort of hard. Yes, I can. All right. All right, let's have a fast enter here, guys. I'm not going to play around. Let's see what my purple count is. I don't think I have any flowers. I also don't think I murdered a lot of people. 23? Yeah, that's really good. Alright, yeah, I know. I'm gonna try to not shit the bed really hard. Whoa, excuse me. first fail. Alright, two times is not bad. I don't care about the one red leaf that isn't coming along with us. It's a loss I'll take. So only a small gold here. I know I can do better if I just get it first try. Oh, not a small gold, but whatever. That can definitely gold split if I just get, if I'm just a little faster, I don't know. This is where it gets a little hard. This was a very good Glutton's Kitchen. Anyways, Air Brake is the future, by the way. One. Oh god, it's the far one. It's fine. Red bugs? No. 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 Good. Oh. Oh, thank fuck. Please never scare me like that again. Oh god. My life flashed before my eyes. Oh lord. That was actually the most Monka Omega thing ever, dude. Oh lord. I literally broke out into a sweat because of that. That was atrocious. Oh, whew. Good RNG. I see it. Red bugs are far. Now this is what I talk about with where I think it's just better to get this one in really fast, and then I already have a decent carry on the other one, but then I can just sub this out. I'm gonna say this thing is ridiculously fast. If you don't know what to do, I feel like you can default to that, right? Like look how quick this is. This is really quick. Even and the RNG was like good, but it wasn't like crazy good, right? Like it's just like it still has to go all the way around. But I think if you think about the RNG like that way, I think that you'll definitely get better Glutton's Kitchen execution. Alright, time for 4 to behave. If Highway Goodness is doing it, I might do something really stupid for the good of the run. Okay, good. Invigorator isn't high at least. And neither is that. Okay, go. Cool. We are in business. I gotta throw a purple on that thing, otherwise a bed bug is gonna take it. I'm sorry, that's just me being cautious. You can't risk that shit. Where did all my whites go? I gotta figure out where all my whites went. They're not dead, but I have 28. Well, 27. Okay, I guess that's... It'd be too slow to try to get those four whites back. Alright, this is bad, but I can make it work. It didn't matter, Eevee. It didn't matter. In this case, it didn't matter. It's fine. Okay, cool. Let's just not shit the bed on 5. 5 also needs to be good. Getting with the last one. Good. Really good. Ridiculously good. Omega lol good. Good. Whatever, I'll just let you play with that a little bit. Excuse me. All right. Really good RNG. See how this plays. This is gonna be very close. Alright. GBB can ruin this run. I only need 3 here. Good. What? No. Oh god, no, idiot. Oh, whatever. I'm figuring this out. That slow descent. Loving it. Oh, I hope I did not get bread bug glitched. I'll be a little mad. No, I have to get Love Nugget. It's unfortunate. Maybe. 1 minute. Let me do some math here. Yeah, I think I have to get Love Nugget. It's bad, but that's how it has to go. It's so close to not being Love Nugget, though. So close. Is 25 worth it? I'll see where Love Nugget is, and I'll make a judgment call. Even saving 20 seconds would be huge, actually, here, so it's fine. Only, like... This is possible. How possible, Lugia? If Love Nugget is close, I'm just gonna get it. It makes way more, because then I don't have to worry about bodies, and then 4 can be done really fast. It's 25, okay, so both Wallys is 10. I just don't like counting, dude. I think counting loses way more time. No, wait a minute. No, that actually does suck, okay. My mission now, if I choose to accept it, is figure out how to get 25 Pokas. This is PB sort of rip, though. Oh god, PB is super ripped. I can't. 25 Pokos and I don't have. Oh boy. RNG is really good, thankfully. Yeah, I know, both Wally's is 10. Then what? Snitch is 4. So that's 11. God, dude, no, this is so hard. Okay, I need 15. 15 divided by 3 is 5. That's 5 Anode Beetles. Let's just get 5 Anode Beetles. Do it. Snitches are 4, but that won't help us. That means we have 3 snitches is the only thing that would equalize it. So we need to get 5 anodes. Okay, cool. Nope, we're wrong. Shut up. That's the direction I want to go. Yeah. All right. All right, that's 3. You know what, this will count as 4. I don't care. All right. And that'll be 5. Okay, good. PB isn't dead, but it's close. Wait, I need one more. Is that the one more that I got? Yes, good. We're in. Alright. This is gonna be hard. Wait, I get to skip BLL. Wait, never mind. We're in. We are in, guys. Oh, fuck you guys. I don't care. Holy crap. Wait, this could do it. This could do it. I forgot we could see BLL. Oh, this is fine. Oh, this run's fine. Oh, this run? Totally fine. Totally forgot we could skip BLL. Oh, yeah. That'll do it. Bad 4. Yeah, okay, cool. This really bad 4. Stop. Alright, this is fine. Alright, fast. No BLL. No BLL. No BLL, no BLL, no BLL. Thank you. Oh, yeah, this is PB. Alright. Man, bats are very complex, though. But I think this is Subkaizen. Nope, not Subkaizen. Close though. It's getting there.